Here's what a ductulator looks like. One of the handier things that a ductulator can do is it can calculate the rectangular duct dimensions to round duct dimensions.
So the first thing you want to do is you want to measure your square duct, and here we have 19 inches on the outside on one end, and it's by 19 inches over here as well.
So what we have is a 19 by 19 square duct. So that square duct, however, is an inch and a half thick. So what we're really going to do is we're going to subtract 3 inches from 19, and we're going to get 16. So what we really have for the inside diameter of that 19 by 19 duct is 16 by 16 on the inside. So now let's find out what the equivalent is if we have a 16 by 16 inch duct. To do that, we turn this dial right here to say, let's line up. See right here, that's 15, one more is 16. So let's find the 16 inch mark, and let's see, about right about there, I think. Wait a minute. Yeah, I think so. It's right about there. So you see that's a 16 by 16. So you see that will line up to the equivalent of the round duct to about over 17. So really you got to go to 18 inches. So that means that the same amount of duct space inside diameter is going to be about 18 inches. Now let's say, just for example, let's say our inside diameter duct was, we'll say, 20, okay, by, we'll say, 25. So we line up 20 with the 25, and that will give us the round duct diameter equivalent of about 24 inches. Now the other handy item that the ductulator is good for is calculating the size of duct that your system really needs. Now, to give you an example, let's say you're designing a return duct to be to have the friction loss, we'll say, right here, okay, of 0.05, just for an example, and you have a 3-ton air conditioning system, okay, rule of thumb, now every manufacturer is different, but rule of thumb is that there's 400 CFMs per ton of air. So let's say your CFMs are 1200, okay, because, well, 3 tons, that's 3 times 400 is 1200 at 0.25. So you've already sort of adjusted the ductulator to that. Okay, see how you can adjust it? So let me put it back to 0.05 to 1200. So what you get is just a little over 17 inches of round duct diameter. So you really got to go up one a little bit more to 18. So you'd be pretty safe to run 18-inch flex for your return duct in this case. Now, let's say, for example, you have a 2-ton air conditioning system. You would adjust your air quantity, CFM, say, to 800, because you see 400 times 2 is 800. 800, remember, let's see, let's adjust 0.25 to 800, okay, right about there. That's about right for friction loss. And we're getting almost 15 inches. So really, you really need to go up to 16 inches because they really don't make 15-inch round flex. So go up to 16 inches and you'd be safe. Now, every air conditioning manufacturer is a little bit different on the design friction loss and the amount of CFMs there are per ton. So you have to find out from their specs and use this ductulator. But generally speaking, you'd be pretty safe on the return side anyway to go with 0.05. The supply is a little bit different. When calculating the supply duct, still always go with manufacturer specifications. But rule of thumb is you can go with a 0.1 for the friction loss and still 400 CFMs per ton. So at 0.1, let's see, we'll line this up to say a 2.5 ton air conditioning system. That would be 1,000 CFMs at 0.1, and that would line up the round duct diameter to be about 14 inches, and that would be what you would need off of from the plenum.